In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we who are weighed down from of hope by slavery beneath the yoke of sin may be set free by the newness of the long-awaited nativity of our only begotten, of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up a righteous shoot to David. As king he shall reign and govern wisely. He shall do what is just and right in the land. In his days Judah shall be saved. Israel shall dwell in security. This is the name they give him, the Lord our justice. Therefore, the days will come, says the Lord, when they shall no longer say, as the Lord lives who brought the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt, but rather, as the Lord lives who brought the descendants of the house of Israel up from the land of the north, and from all the lands to which I banished them, and they shall again live on their own land. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, justice shall flourish in his time and fullness of peace forever. Justice shall flourish in his time and fullness of peace forever. O God, with your judgment endow the king, and with your justice the king's son. He shall govern your people with justice and your afflicted ones with judgment. Justice shall flourish in his time and fullness of peace forever. For he shall rescue the poor when he cries out, and the afflicted when he has no one to help him. He shall have pity for the lowly and the poor, the lives of the poor he shall save. Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, who alone does wondrous deeds, and blessed forever be his glorious name. May the whole earth be filled with his glory. Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever.
This is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about, when his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph. But before they lived together, she was found with child through the Holy Spirit. Joseph, her husband, since he was a righteous man, yet unwilling to expose her to shame, decided to divorce her quietly. Such was his intention when, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary, your wife, into your home. For it is through the Holy Spirit that this child has been conceived in her. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said to the prophet, "Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us." When Joseph awoke, he did as the angel of the Lord had commanded him, and took his wife into his home. He had no relation with her until she bore a son, and he named him Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord. Because we hear the term Emmanuel in only two books of the Bible, Isaiah and Matthew, in relation to the birth of Jesus, it's easy to miss its overall meaning. God is with us. That means Emmanuel is not just a baby in a manger, but our Savior, who is with us always, in times of joy, times of sadness, and everywhere in between, every day, all day. And now we offer our prayers and petitions to our Heavenly Father. For our Holy Father and all church leaders, may the blessing of Almighty God be upon them, especially during this Advent season. Let us pray to the Lord. For public authorities across the world, may the Lord bless them with wisdom in the policy making and the government. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who grieve for loved ones lost in the past year, may God give them strength, peace, and consolation in the midst of their mourning. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who have died in the light of Christ, especially Prospero Santiago and Christina Zielinska, may they find the comfort and the eternal joy with God. Let us pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, trusting in your great love and mercy, we pray that you hear and answer these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, God, our creation, for the goodness we have seen the bread we offer, the fruit of the earth, the fruit of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, God, of creation, for the goodness we have seen the wine we offer, the fruit of the vine and the work of human hands, will become our speech, our dream.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our service. Almighty eternal God through Christ our Lord. For he assumed his first time in the loneliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you from long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty and all his blessed may manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with the thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we are praying.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are in the holy Lord, the fount of all holiness, made holy, therefore at these days we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he prayed, and giving a thanks, broke and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving it thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith we proclaim.
We serve the Lord and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving it thanks that you have heard us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread it throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis of Pope and Blaise of Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all who have died in your mercy. Welcome and thank you to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, the Most Holy Spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with St. Zachary, and all the saints that please of God be, we may merit to be coerced into the light, and may praise and glorify you, your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, and I in you of God for Holy Spirit, all glory be and honor be yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and from by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that thou, by the help of your mercy, may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peter, I lead you, my Peter, I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with the world, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Thank you.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold, Lamb of God, behold the hem of the days of the sins of the world. Blessed are those who go to the supper glad.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word of my soul shall be blessed.
May the Father bless you and save your life. May the blood of Christ be saved to life. Let us pray. May we receive your mercy in the midst of your temple, O Lord, and show a fitting honor to the coming solemnities of our redemption. Through Christ the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The mass is ended. Go in peace.